So round 5, I spent a couple of my primary years there. So part of the things that I did there was the knitting club, because I had a passion for knitting. I got to mentor the younger ones. I got to give to the community. I got to learn a new skill I found relaxing, and I had to show my leadership. So giving to the community, first of all, in grade 4, we had to do a project, all creatures great and small. And so I had to learn to knit to make a blanket for the Keysborough Animal Shelter, and we did do that. Then in grade 6, my friends and I decided to take over the knitting club from the teachers, and we decided to make 2 blankets with the help of from preps to grade 4. We made 2 and we donated them to Springvale Benevolent Society. So that was some of them. So that was one that we made to the animal shelter, and then that was the knitting club group. So the Enigma portal, I also had to show my leadership, my teaching and learning tools, my teamwork and problem solving, my research skill, reflecting. I did it with 2 other friends. We did it on linguistics and the human brain. So that was pretty amazing to figure out all that stuff. We had to learn to problem solve in different ways. So if there was a website that we wanted to go to make it easy, we had to learn to use keywords instead of just writing the whole question in. We got to teach some grades as well that were interested as well. So that's where we got to learn. And I remember cutting out like 100 brains just so they could do a puzzle. It took me a while.
So Tamara, does the Enigma portal, can you just explain a little bit about what the Enigma portal is?
It's like you've got these 3 iPads, you've got 3 screens, and they're not connected, you can connect them up. And so you can look at different websites, or you can look at them all together, or you can look at the maps, or so you connect them all together.
So that's actually a learning space, yeah.
And is it connected to the TV in the back? Is that a TV in the background?
Yeah, there's like these 3 TVs that is a computer as well.
And so do groups of children take it in turns to do a special project?
Well, we were one of the first people to use it because it had just been built, so we were just trying to get it started. Mm-hmm. So there was a lot of stop, start in it just so we could get going. So there are some other ones that are in the units.
Which was your favourite?
Easily.
So what grade level is that in? 1, 2, is it?
That's prep. 3, 2.
Right.
That was in the green screener. We did have a green screener.
Okay.
So the RSCB Energy Breakthrough Challenge was another thing that I was a part of. So we had to use our teamwork to learn about the aerodynamics. Fundraising, the logo design, and lots and lots of decision making and negotiation. So with the teamwork, there was a couple of us that didn't know how to work in a team, and we had to try and show them that we are not competing against each other, we're trying to work as a team. With the fundraising, that made a lot of arguments because some people didn't want them to, they just wanted to have it their way. Again, that showed the way that we had to do the teamwork. With the aerodynamics, that was part of my part to design the vehicle. We did it in a teardrop shape because it would be faster. That's a very aerodynamic, and we also had to make our license. The autonomous learning group was part of everything, I reckon. I had to show leadership, reflection on daily learning, knowing and identifying my challenges and strengths, collaborating with my teacher for strategies to support my learning, encouraging my curiosity, and provoking my new thoughts. When we would talk to the teacher, we would sit down and say, okay, I need help with my maths. So we might show different ways of working on my maths to help me get better at it. Provoking my new thoughts, we would have the circle time, and we would talk about a sentence that the teacher would give us. Is life fair was one of them. So we had to provoke what we were going to think about. So not just like,
No, well, yes, we have to explain why and how it could change.
Developing my interest in early childhood. The teacher saw me reading a book of my mum's because I found it interesting. That was also got me, I got to work with the preps a couple of times, just to understand the way they think and do that stuff.
Oh, so you actually did some of like the conservation experiments and things like that? Yeah.
So the Spanish teaching I did last year, I had to show leadership to my friends. I got to develop my teaching skills and activities. I got to keep practicing my father's heritage language.
Does he speak Spanish too? Are you fluent in Spanish?
Kind of, because he does go away, so then we don't practice it. Last year he was away, and then I was actually put in the French group, but my friends and I said we don't want to do French, we want to do Spanish, and no one else is doing it, so we thought we're going to do it instead. We're not going to do French. We are in French this year, and it's confusing me slightly. It sounds the
same.
But I got a B in it, and I just said, I think it's because I was partly speaking Spanish, it's going to sound like it's a bit.
Whatever works.
Yeah. I also made the teddy bears here. I made a couple of them.
Oh, they're gorgeous.
Can you meet clothes?
I'm trying.
Like baby stuff.
Very nice. Thank you. I'm sure we've all got lots of questions for you there, Tamara.
Do
you
want to look at your tents?
A brown one, it's like Mr. Bain's.
Yeah. Well,
soft.
Do you want to just have a seat, Tamara, and perhaps we'll just have a give people a chance to ask some questions about what life at Warana Park has been like?
Probably that I got to go into different rooms and not have the teacher watch me all the time. I could just go off and do my thing.
So what would a typical day be like for you?
Well, we would start off, we would have these learning journeys and it would fill out our goals, how we're going to do our goals, and what we were going to do during the day and how we were going to achieve it. And then we'd go to our classes, and if we had a goal in that class, we'd write it down for next week so we could try that goal.
So what was different, because obviously you went there in grade 2, so what were the big differences for you from your last
When I got there in grade 2, I was expecting all these worksheets. So I was really confused that they just said, I had no clue what learning agreement was. Everyone's like, oh yes, we've got LA. I'm like, what is that? What is that? And then it took me a while to get used to the way we did.
How much of the day would the learning agreement time take up? Was it every day or just a few times a week?
We did it nearly every day, if we had something special in the night. But it was often, we did it maybe after recess and before lunch. So we were doing that every day.
So the other parts of the day you would still have like a maths lesson?
Yeah.
But there would be a substantial block of each day to work on your own learning agreement projects. But you have your own goals, would you, with your... So your maths, you have a goal for that maths for that day. So maybe the next lesson is probably not going to be the typical worksheet type lesson.
No, you've got to break off into groups and then work on it that way.
So your classroom, well, they're not called classrooms.
No, they're called units, because we mix a lot. We don't have, like, A, B, C or anything like we do, but that's just for, like, 15 minutes to do the role, then we just mix.
So multi-age.
Yeah.
So in your unit, was it prep 1-2 or...
So we have like 5-6 units and all that, but we can move around the unit, and then if we have something maybe we wanted to do in the grade 2 unit, if we were part of the autonomous learning group, we could then move.
So the units are sort of grade based, but there might be the equivalent of 3 grades within that unit.
Yeah, and maybe once a term we would have a multi-age day where everyone was given a group number, and then it was like from prep to 6 we just all moved.
Did you have like a buddy program too where you would work with?
No, we didn't really do that. We did want to do that, but I guess the teachers were a bit concerned about the way that the preps would feel, because there are some girls that actually did take the preps and then they kind of needed them all the time. But if we were a leader, there was this boy, Zach, he was autistic, and so at lunch maybe we'd go and help him play with him at lunch.
Have any a good question. Was there tests and things like that too?
Just to see where we're at learning, but we didn't do them often. So
right. Just... Yeah. But you still did NAPLAN?
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us about NAPLAN, doing NAPLAN?
None of us liked it. We were just like, oh, NAPLAN again.
But you didn't spend weeks leading up to it practicing?
No, basically it. Just the week before, they said we're just going to do NAPLAN, so if you feel like you need to do anything, just let us know.
How have you found moving into high school?
Very easy. Yeah. It was just like, yeah, it was okay.
And did you have friends go to the same high school?
I had two go, yeah. So that was okay. Yeah.
Awesome.
And you said how you found it different going from your old school to your new school. What's the question I'm trying to ask? How does it compare for you personally?
Well, we were put in, at my old school, we were put in a room, and that was the room that we'd stay in for the whole day, and so we had electives to go to. It was very different because we were given worksheet after worksheet, and now I think about it, I don't really know how we changed from maths to English or anything like that. So it was just, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's
very similar. Structure of what my girls do is good. But they have a sit down learning environment, but they do break off into.
Mm. I think a lot of schools are picking up on that sort of thing, and especially with the new buildings with open plan spaces, they've had to rethink their pedagogy.
What were the sizes of the class? So, the hub, not the classroom, the unit.
They were pretty big, but it depends on if they could drag and grade in, because it was up and down stairs. So it would make the room smaller.
Oh, because can that move in
there? No, it's just like there, but they've got an up and down, so they've got like maybe a library up. So.
And how many children would be
in the room? I know in the 5-6 we had around 100, but it depends on how many enrolled we prep and then move.
Yeah.
I'm not really sure.
So even in the next time, that 100 would be mixed up into different groups?
Yeah, so we had group 1, 2, 3 and 4, so that was... You know, so we wouldn't be with our friends. Maybe sometimes we might be, sometimes we wouldn't be. It was basically so we could have more friends who weren't born.
Yeah. So working across a wide group.
What was it in the age group? Different age groups in one group? Or
The units at sort of grade level or grade 5-6? Grade 5-6 together? Or?
Yeah, 5-6. They were 3 and 4, but then that changed when we did up the new hall into the spaceship. And so it's only 5-6 that are together now.
Okay, so yeah, the others are great. All the grade 1s together, all the grade 2s together.
It used to be 1-2, the preps were always by themselves, but then they got new classrooms, and so then they just went prep 1-2, used to be 3-4, but then that changed, now it's just 5-6 together.
Okay.
Yeah, which would have been in line with the Bells bands, because prep was level 1, level 1, 2 was level 2.
Yeah.
And now with the Australian curriculum, there's much more individual levels. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions for Tamara?
So going from your old school to your new school, do you think that was a much better environment for you? You felt a much better learning environment?
Yeah. For me, I guess we looked at other schools, I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah.
But then I went to this, I'm just like, oh, maybe mine.
Okay. So as soon as you walked through the door, you were interested.
It was like a good energy.
What about your friends from your old school? Do you still have contact with them?
Not as much, because they all went different. Like, they all got really teenage-y. It's like, because we see them and they wear, like, all this makeup and really short dresses now. Yeah. So it's just like, maybe.
How have they changed to where you are?
And do you think that the learning environment at Wirana Park suits everybody, or were there kids there that struggled a bit with the
kids that did struggle, but then they had teachers that would help them.
How was their reporting?
It's the same.
But I think supplemented by a lot of this, learning portfolios and the extra, the audio stuff.
Do you guys wear uniform or do you go in?
Yeah, but it's not as strict as some schools, because there are some families that are poor, so they can't afford it. So if it's just close enough to the school uniform. But they do encourage students to wear the school uniform.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a very multicultural school too.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Something like, how many languages are spoken there?
A lot.
Yeah. Something on the website, but yeah, it's in Dandenong, so it's many, many different cultures in there. Anything else?
Can you see this type of school happening anywhere else in Metropolitan?
I'd like to, but I guess people still like the way the chairs.
The old traditional.
Mm. Well, all they need is to have Tamara come and speak to them. Comforts, don't you think?
Absolutely.
It just
sounds
good.
Happy
birthday. Yes.
Thank you.
Any last questions for Tamara?
No.
Well, thank you very much, Tamara. We have a little present for you. And we really appreciate it. It's great to hear it from the student's perspective, isn't it? It's very easy to think about it theoretically and philosophically, but it's really important to hear how it feels for a student. So thank you very much, Tamara.
Thank you.
And enjoy the rest of your day. I'll turn this off.
Tamara, did your mum meet?